What's going on, guys? My name is Prestige. Welcome to episode number 9 of a little series that I like to call Epic Weapons of Infinite Warfare. In this series, we take a look at all of the epic weapons inside of Infinite Warfare. I let you know whether or not they're worth the 4,000 salvage or just completely forgetting in the armory. If you happen to miss any of the previous 8 episodes, you can find a complete playlist linked down below in the description and at the end of this video in the form of an annotation. But without further ado, let's get into today's episode where we are going to be talking about the HVR Gemini. This epic variant brings two very distinctive perks to the table, the first one being Twin Sanity. This is going to allow you to dual wield the HVR SMG. In Infinite Warfare, you can't normally use the akimbo attachment on SMGs, so this is actually a really interesting epic variant. Next up, we have Readiness. This is going to allow you to reload faster when your magazine's empty, and it does stack with Dexterity, which I am using in this gameplay here. Also, if you guys want to get this SMG right now, you can because it's unlockable at rank 50 with the Saber Team 7 mission team. You don't have to worry about getting it out of a supply drop or using salvage with this one, and I gotta say, it's one of the most unique epic variants that we've come across so far in the series, and when I'm using this thing, no lie, it reminds me of the dual wield or akimbo attachment from Modern Warfare 2 when I used to use the dual wield UMP45s, the dual wield MP5Ks. It just reminds me of that, and I absolutely love it. So one of the biggest complaints that I saw people talking about when it came to this particular variant was the fire rate, and if you guys couldn't tell from this video, the fire rate is a little bit slower compared to the standard or base model HVR, and there are a couple of different reasons why this happens. The first reason, it should be obvious, but I'll let you guys know anyway, it's simply for balancing reasons. This is the only dual wield SMG in Infinite Warfare. If the fire rate was similar to the standard HVR, you would be a complete tank. I feel like you could be a complete tank anyway with this particular variant, but the same thing goes. This is meant for balancing purposes, for people to actually have a chance to come back at you. You're using two SMGs, you're firing double the amounts of bullets at your enemies, with an improved hip spread, with the ability to put the laser sight on there, you can be a literal tank with this weapon anyway, but just imagine with the higher fire rate, you'd be completely unstoppable. And secondly, I feel like if the fire rate was any higher, it would be really hard to control. There would be a lot of recoil going on, and you're gonna see this happening when we get to the Zombies in Spaceland portion of this video. So let's talk a little bit about the class setup when it comes to this particular weapon. There aren't that many attachments that you're able to choose from. You actually have the laser sight, the extended magazine, the suppressor, FMJ, and rifled barrel. There are only two attachments that I would recommend this time around, that easily being the extended magazine and of course the laser sight. Anything you can do to improve your overall hip fire accuracy is definitely going to help here. That means more bullets landing on target and more kills for you. Now, I was actually having a pretty fun time using this weapon with the suppressor attachment and the ghost perk as well. Being able to run around with the suppressors and ghosts just kind of gave me that even more of a Modern Warfare 2 vibe. Trust me, try it out if you can. It's a lot of fun. The other thing I would recommend is the gung-ho perk. Gung-ho is going to allow you to fire while sprinting, and this definitely can help when you're running up behind an enemy or running head into an enemy. This will allow you to easily take them out without having to stop what you're doing in order to fire your weapon. Sliding and jumping is going to be your friend as well. If you're sliding, you'll have full access to your weapons, and since you're hip firing them, you'll be able to easily take out enemies no sweat. Now that we know the HVR Gemini is a badass in the multiplayer, how does it fare against the undead horde in Zombies in Spaceland? And I gotta say, it's my favorite variant in Zombies in Spaceland at the moment because it is a major point builder. For those that didn't know, there are a couple of different places you could buy the HVR off of the wall, over by the Slappy Taffy machine, and of course underground in the maintenance tunnels. The cool thing behind this is when you apply the extended magazine, you get 45 rounds in each of your weapons, and this works very well. You can take out brutes very quickly, you're able to mow down hordes of zombies super quick up until I believe like round 18, 19, 20-ish, it still works very, very well. After getting the Bang Bang's candy perk, that's when things start flying off the hinges a little bit. You have an increased fire rate and of course increased damage output, and that fire rate basically goes up above what the base HVR can do, and this is what I was talking about earlier on in the video. With that increased fire rate, the recoil is pretty heavy. It's kind of hard to control, hard to just aim and try to get headshots with this weapon, and it would just be absolutely crazy to have something like that in the multiplayer. But by far, the best thing that this thing does in Zombies in Spaceland is getting packed, getting pack-a-punched, guys. This thing is absolutely beautiful. It still comes out dual-wield, by the way, and you have 75 rounds in each magazine. The coolest part behind this is if you train up all of the zombies and you get ready to just mow them down, you will instantly get over $4,500, 4,500 points, and you can buy more ammo off the wall if you really, really wanted to. There's over 500 rounds in your reserve and 75 rounds in each magazine. That's absolutely crazy. The other positive to this is a complete brute shredder. You can take out brutes like nobody's business. I mean, instantaneously. It is crazy how fast these things go down. And another thing that I was using, like I said before, it's a crazy point builder. You can just build points like nobody's business. I was putting on the Mule Munchies candy perk, and I'd buy two weapons off of the wall. I would go ahead and pack-a-punch those weapons. Then I'd come back and swap them out for two more weapons, earn more points with the HVR, go back in, pack-a-punch some more. And I was earning so much experience by doing that simply by using these two HVR submachine guns here. So when it comes down to it, is it worth the grind to go to level 50 on your mission team for Saber Team 7? And I'm gonna say absolutely. If you're somebody that plays zombies in Spaceland a majority of the time, this is definitely a really nice variant to have. It's super, super epic when it comes down to how many points you can get, how easy it is to mow down the brutes and the zombies in general. This is just a really nice overall weapon that you can buy off the wall. Secondly, if you are more into the multiplayer aspect of Infinite Warfare, you are not going to regret it. This thing does bring back the nostalgic factor of dual-wielding weapons back from Modern Warfare 2. In fact, using it in the multiplayer was some of the most fun that I've ever had in core game modes. And that's something that I can't say often because I just don't like core game modes. It's pretty cool to know that it does mow down enemies pretty successfully, even though the fire rate may be decreased a little bit. Making sure that you have that laser sight and extended mag attached will make sure you have enough firepower to take out the next enemy that may cross your path. But I am gonna give this weapon my seal of approval. If you're somebody who's in the multiplayer or if you're somebody's in the zombies community, this is definitely gonna be a great weapon for you. Grind out that rank 50, get yourself the Gemini, and go to town. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Epic Weapons of Infinite Warfare. If you guys did, make sure to click the like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And if you guys are subscribed to the channel, make sure to click the little bell notification button next to the subscribe button and stay notified on when I upload each and every day. Until next time, guys, I will see ya.
Peace.